back in the Bee Bad Lounge with Seth Jones. Hello, Seth.
Hi, nice to meet you. And yourself, yes.
You've come all the way from Wales today, quite a long trip.
Yeah, I've come from Bangor, is where we've come from today. I was training in the boxing club at the Bangor University there.
So, how long did it take you to get here?
Approximately 3 hours, 3.5 hours.
So, fairly long.
Yeah, it was quite a journey.
Seth, tell us about what you've been doing over the years, like fight wise.
When I was fighting when I was younger, I won a couple of titles, Welsh titles, as a schoolboy.
Boxing would that
boxing,
be?
Boxing, yes. And then I went on and did some professional boxing. Didn't really have a blistering career or any such thing. I think I won 3 out of 9 or 10.
Yeah.
But I had a dislocated shoulder at the time, which was quite a disadvantage.
But you still carried on?
Yeah, I still tried, but I thought, you know, it was best to quit before I got hurt or before anything happened. But then over the years, when I was resting from boxing, I've gone into training and coaching. And my shoulder these days seems to have improved to an extent where it doesn't pop out.
So can you train like you used to?
Yeah, I can still train. I haven't trained like I used to recently because I'm getting a bit older now and I'm finding it a bit more. The legs don't carry it quite the same. But I've been training on and off now for the last five years. I was with a boxing club in Colne Bay. My brother's taken on the gym, the Boxlands gym. I went on to Bangor University to study law. And whilst at Bangor University, we've established a boxing club there.
Train there as well? You teach there as well?
I'm really more of a coach than a boxer myself. And the opportunity came up, I was considering writing a book and stuff about the way my life's gone.
Yeah.
The way I've turned my life around as well, and ended up studying law.
You're still doing that now?
I'm in my final year at the moment.
So how long has that taken you? That takes a few years, doesn't it?
Well, up to now, I had to do the access course, and then I've gone on, so I've been studying now 3 years. When I finish, it'll be 4 years.
Right.
But then I think I've got to take another LPC course after that.
So we'll be seeing you in one of the wigs?
Not sure about the wigs, but I might be doing the solicitor, become a solicitor.
Like brief, all that
sort of stuff in the magistrate's court.
But you still stick to your training, coaching and...
Yeah, I mean, I'm really interested in coaching and I'm hoping in the future that I can develop some of the fighters or certainly help them along the way into developing a good career for themselves.
You're doing bare knuckle and you coach boxing. Is there much difference apart from just no gloves, or is it the training style?
Well, I think that apart from there being no gloves, I wouldn't say there was much difference.
No.
I mean, the early days of boxing, that's where it all began. They didn't wear gloves, and then they took on hand wraps, and then they took on leather mitts, and it's progressed to there. So now there's, you know, there's varying rules, and obviously, you know, obviously bare knuckle there is rules still.
Yeah.
But it's without the gloves, so it's really going back to
the
original days of boxing.
So last couple of days, have you taken your training day? Have you been resting?
Last week I've not done any of my runs. I've stayed in the gym, done some gym work, and then Thursday we did finished off with a circuit on Thursday. And then nothing else really, so I've trained Monday, Thursday, and that's all this week.
So you seem like a really placid fella, like, you know, if I see you walking down the road, I wouldn't picture you as a fighter. Is this, do you get this often with people, are they sort of shocked if you tell them? Especially doing law as well.
Yeah,
you know.
I think it's come as quite a shock that some of the students and the Law Society in Bangor have actually read on my status on Facebook and heard that I was actually going to have a go at this.
Yeah.
And I think it has come as a huge shock to them, but I think it's interesting as well because it's something I'd like to do, and it's something that I can say, well, I've done that.
Yeah.
You know, I might never be the best, or I don't anticipate being the best in the future, but I've had a go at it.
Is this your first BKB fight?
This would be my first BKB fight, yes.
So, I mean, when you're training, you use gloves, obviously.
Yeah, mostly use gloves. I've been using the last couple of weeks just on the pads and on the bags without the gloves, but... just to really feel what it feels like. I will be wearing bandages, you know, to protect my hands as such. And
what do other boxers that you know think of you doing this? Because there's a bit of a gap. Some people think BKB's terrible, and others are like interested, but they don't want to say too much, you know.
Some of the boxers that I've spoken to have said, "Are you sure you want to do this? You know, are you?" You know, it's going to hurt and stuff. I said, well, you know, it's going to hurt regardless, you know, with gloves or without gloves.
Yeah.
And it can't be no different than sort of like having a fight when you're drunk or something, you know.
Yeah.
Although I wouldn't go to that extent as such, but...
Because obviously BKB is associated with gypsies and gangsters, isn't it, a lot of the time, you know, a lot of people are under the impression it's...
Yeah, there is an association that is associated with travellers and gypsies, and there's a gangster image that surrounds it, really.
Well, now we've got a lawyer.
Well, someone to defend it.
So you are nervous, a bit nervous tonight. It's,
yeah, I mean, obviously, I feel a little bit edgy, as it were, anticipating and more of a concentration type of a nervousness.
Yeah.
I don't really have a fear or any such thing as that. I suppose it's generally the same type of nerves as I would have felt when I was boxing in them days.
Yeah.
So, there is that.
Are you going back to Wales tonight after the fight, or are you staying around?
Well, that all depends how the fight goes, to be honest. If the fight goes well, we'll be travelling back tonight and stopping at KFC on the way. But we might stay and have a couple of pints as well, so we're not so sure of what we'll actually be doing after the fight.
Seth, man, it's been a pleasure chatting to you. Thanks very much. Good luck tonight.
Thank you
we'll be watching.
Much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Cheers.